Let's face it, many times in the NFL, things don't work out for your favorite team. Bad ownership, silly draft picks, stupid play calls, contract negotiations, even relocation. All the while, we the fans have to sit idly by wondering just why they make the baffling decisions they do that leave us all a miserable wreck of mumbling maniacs on Sundays. But with fantasy football, none of that matters, because you are in charge. You're the one guiding your team towards their ultimate destiny. Today, as the defending champion of the Gila River Fantasy League, I'm proud to present you with this insider look into what goes into running a successful fantasy franchise. You know, it's been said that there's nothing more difficult in professional football than defending your championship. You've got a target on your back, everybody's out gunning for you, and they're going to fight you tooth and nail for every last point. So this year, to solidify my spot as the team to beat, I've enlisted the help of some close friends whose vast knowledge and experience of the NFL is going to help keep us on top. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce to you my good friend Mike, who's joining us via satellite today. Mike is going to be our new director of player personnel. Mike, how are you doing today?
Today was good for me.
Mike, I was wondering if you could sum up for everyone out there our team philosophy this year.
We go out, we hit people in the mouth.
Absolutely. So, Mike, when you're assessing what goes into a successful fantasy team, it's important to keep in mind the league structure. Our guidelines are staying the same this year. We're utilizing full PPR, we're starting two flex, and we're carrying an 8-man bench. And we have a full league of 12 teams again this year.
I would rather play with 10 people.
We're pretty well locked into 12 at this point, Mike. It just means there's that many more players on NFL rosters that need to be evaluated. And Mike, I was wondering if you could tell us, when you're starting to evaluate a player, what's the biggest factor you consider?
I want guys that are solution-oriented.
Can you explain what you mean by that a little bit?
I want winners.
So does that mean...
I want people that want to win.
I certainly do, too. Okay, I'll tell you what, let's have a little fun here. I want to throw some names out to you, and I want you to give me your gut feeling on them, sort of a rapid-fire evaluation session, okay? Give me your opinion on Andrew Luck.
I cannot play with him.
Okay, how about Larry Fitzgerald?
Cannot win with him.
Okay, one more. What are your thoughts on Le'Veon Bell?
Cannot coach with him.
Can you think of any team that would be willing to sign Johnny Manziel?
Can't do it.
Okay, Mike, thanks for your time today. I'm looking forward to working with you this year. You know, there are so many things I'm looking forward to in the 2016 NFL season, but perhaps none more than in Week 5, when we get to witness the return of the greatest receiver and greatest American in the history of fantasy football. Now, as we all know, there's all sorts of financial numbers, scheduling, statistics, and other figures that need to be assessed in fantasy football. So, in order to sort out some of these considerations, we've brought in a very solid football mind. He's got an incredible amount of experience. He's going to be a very valuable asset to this franchise as our new director of analytics. So, let's bring him in. Jim, have you had a chance to look over the schedule yet? What do you think of our first matchup, Week 1?
I don't care. Who you play?
Well, there's definitely something to be said for that. After all, you've got to go out there and give your best effort regardless of who's out there against you. Last year, about mid-season, we dropped some games to some opponents we felt we should have handled easily.
In my opinion, that sucked.
I agree. But let's talk about our projections for this season. I know you've been crunching some numbers. What's your opinion of our outlook?
What's that?
Do you think we'll be right there in the playoff hunt again this year?
Playoffs? Talk about playoffs? You kidding me?
I'm serious.
Playoffs?
Well, what do you think would be a realistic expectation for this season?
I just hope we can win a game.
Okay, okay. It seems like we have a confidence problem in some parts of the organization, but I have just the man for the job. He's going to get us all on the same page. He's going to get us fired up this year. Ladies and gentlemen, it's our new morale officer, Bart Scott. Bart, how did it feel when you learned you were going to be part of the administrative staff this year?
Feel great.
Bart, there's some folks out there who think we can't do it all again this year.
Anybody can be beat.
Some people out there say we're going to be shut down.
They can't stop a nosebleed.
They think last year was a fluke.
We're a good football team.
Or that we're not working as hard as we should.
We're pissed off.
How's it going to be when we prove them all wrong again?
Poetic justice.
Are you ready to bring home another championship?
Can't wait.
And neither can I. Fantasy football season is here again, and we'll see you at the draft.